Hey everyone, what's up? Matt here from SoundSwitch, and in this tutorial video, we're going to show you how to get up and running with the Control 1 and Virtual DJ in performance mode. So let's get into it. So in this video, we're going to be focused on setting up the Control 1 and Virtual DJ in performance mode. If you're looking for information on how to get set up for the very first time, or you want more information about the detailed features of the Control 1, check out the links in the description below for some more helpful videos. Now, the first thing you need to do is make sure that you have SoundSwitch 2.5 or later installed on your Mac or PC, and make sure that the application is running. Once the app is running, you can connect the USB port to either port 1 or port 2 on the back of the device and connect it to your laptop. Make sure that the USB switch on the top of the device selects the appropriate USB port, and if not, the controller will let you know with displaying a warning on the screen. This is telling me to switch to port 1, and now I'm good to go. You also want to make sure that the USB and DMX connections are both connected, with the DMX connection going out to your lights from either Universe 1 or 2, depending on your setup. For most users, that will be Universe 1, but if you have a large lighting rig and you have lots of fixtures, you're going to want to connect both Universes 1 and 2 and have that set up appropriately in the software. So once you have your output connected and you have your USB input connected, you can jump over into performance mode and select your venue. Now, in this particular example, I'm using the Gig Bar Move from Chevet DJ, and I'll be using the pre-built venue for the Gig Bar Move that is shipped with the SoundSwitch software. So I'll select that, and that will automatically bring me into the performance mode screen where I can see all of my overrides and my live controls for my lighting. You'll also see a bit of output on your lights. And the first thing you're going to want to do to make sure that everything is set up and configured correctly is by turning on the white color override. Now, if all of your lights turn white, you can be pretty confident that your lights are set up correctly and that the Control 1 is working to control your lights. Turn that override off and select another color override. And again, if all of your colors match that color override, you can be confident that you have everything set up. If some of your lights are a different color, or some of them are strobing or behaving oddly, you might want to check the DMX settings in the SoundSwitch edit mode to make sure everything is patched and set up correctly. So now that we know that the Control 1 and SoundSwitch software are communicating and set up properly, we can switch over to Virtual DJ and we'll play back a couple of tracks. So the first thing we want to do is load tracks to both decks and then press play with our fader up and our crossfader to the left. And once we press play, that light show will start to play back. If I pause the light show will pause. And if I move the record forward or backwards, the light show will play back in time. Now, if I crossfade over to the right-hand side, I can play back that light show by lifting up the fader and switching over. Now remember, SoundSwitch uses the fader positions to decide which light show to play back. So if you just mix with your up faders, make sure you've selected the up fader only option in SoundSwitch. And if you use your crossfader, make sure you use either blend, cut, or scratch mode. If you have any more questions about those fader modes, please reach out and let us know. Another thing you can do to make sure that the connection is working inside Virtual DJ is to switch the pad matrix from Qs to DMX. Then you can press any of the DMX buttons on the screen to force the connection between Virtual DJ and SoundSwitch. This is a helpful test that if you load tracks and you don't see any playback on your lighting system, it might be that SoundSwitch and Virtual DJ are not communicating together. This test allows you to force that connection to make sure that everything is working properly. So now that you've got your tracks loaded, and that you have SoundSwitch running with the Control 1, we can start to look at some of the different features of the Control 1 and how you can get this running and control your lights on the fly. So the most important features of the Control 1, and where this differs from using an interface, is that you have a full matrix of controls at your fingertips for that tactile control over your lighting effects. So let's say I have no song playing and I just want to build up a bit of a scene. All I need to do is add some movement, add a color override, and then I can dial in the speed and the size of that movement effect. If I want to customize what effect is launched when pressing that button, I can select the menu, I can select the effects option, then I can select movement, and I can choose which movement effect I would like to apply to that button. So now I'll go from a figure eight to a circle. Or I can switch to scanning horizontally or scanning vertically, or go back to that circle effect again. And that allows me to control all of that without switching the interface on the desktop software. If you do want to make changes in the desktop software, say you want to change the color of an override, you can right click, select color, and change that color to something different. Doing so will update the LED feedback on the button itself. And you're able to also change the toggle and press modes on any of these buttons by again right clicking on the button and selecting for press or toggle mode. So now I can toggle that lighting effect on and off by simply pressing it and releasing it. Or if I want it to latch on and toggle on, I switch to toggle mode and I can toggle that effect on and it will stay on even if my hands aren't on the controller. There's MIDI feedback lighting to let you know what effects are active. So if you want to turn those effects off, you can simply select them again and you'll go back to the light show that's playing. You have auto loop buttons and all of the individual auto loop controls down the bottom. So you can play a single bank, or if you hold shift, you can switch back to playing all banks as well. You can set the pad matrix from auto loop mode into the static look mode, and now you're able to activate any of the static looks that come pre-shipped with SoundSwitch if you're using the gig bar move or your custom static looks that you've set up for your custom lighting rig. To turn these off, you can turn them off again, and if you do have a static look on and you switch back to auto loop mode, you'll see that that static look will let you know that it's playing underneath, which is really important to give you that heads up feedback of what lighting effects are on. This is the same case for the position overrides. If you hold shift, you can then spotlight a particular position and you can see that the MIDI feedback lighting is letting you know that there's a position override active under that color override, which is really helpful to let you know again what effects are latched on and which effects are not. So here I'll turn that static look off and I'll turn that position cue off. And the only other feature that we'll cover off in this video is the ability to scale the intensity using the touch strip. So here you can switch between auto loop and scripted tracks, so you can adjust the intensity for your lights for those particular track types. You also have the ability to toggle into group one, group three. If you double tap, you can go into groups two and group four. This is a quick way to be able to dial in the lighting intensity for the particular fixtures that you've set up with your different control groups. Now, if you have any questions about the Control One and how to get it set up, please reach out to support@soundswitch.com or send us a message on Facebook or Instagram Messenger. You can also join the user group and share your videos of how you're using the Control One with your setup so other users can be impressed by the work that you're putting in. If you need any help again, feel free to reach out and we'll see you in another video.